afternoon. Welcome to our viewers at home for our 20th annual holiday service of remembrance. Although this is our 20th service, this is the first year that we are broadcasting our service. We're live streaming on our website, and a recording of the service will be available on our website next week as well. I wish to thank those who are helping us, our team from Horvath Funeral Service, Father Anthony Stubita, Holy Redeemer Church, Pastor Lyle Snyder, St. Stephen's Lutheran Church, and our musicians, Emily Dorschner and Dana Funk. We understand that when a death occurs, families grieve that loss. Many times the grief is more difficult during special events like the holidays, as we understand that old traditions have ended and new traditions are beginning. This year, grief is compounded by the COVID virus, as many families are not able to conduct any gatherings at all, or limited gatherings, whether at funeral time or during the holidays. This is difficult because we understand that grief shared is grief diminished. So, although we're gathering virtually, online gatherings do not replace a warm hug from a friend or family, but they do serve as a reminder that you are never alone. So thank you for taking the time to tune in today, and please know that we are here for you. At this time, I will invite Pastor Lyle Snyder forward to offer our opening prayer.
Let us pray. God with us, Emmanuel, you made this holy season shine with the brightness of the true light, your Son. Grant that as we are here on earth, as we remember those who've passed, our loved ones, our family, and our friends, that as we walk in the light of Jesus spreads, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory, through your only Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We sing our opening hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
As we light these four candles in honor of our loved ones who have died, we gather in the name of the one who brings light into our darkness, including the darkness of grief and sorrow. We light one candle for our grief, one for our courage, one for our memories, and one for our love. Our first candle. This candle represents our grief. The pain and sense of loss is intense. It reminds us of the depth of our love for you and how much we miss you. Our second candle. This candle represents our courage to confront our sorrow, to comfort each other, and to look to God who brings us strength in the midst of our grief. Our third candle. This light is in your memory. The times we laughed, the times we cried, the times we were angry with each other, the silly things you did, the caring and joy you gave us. And our fourth candle. This light is the light of love as we enter this holiday season. Day by day, we cherish this special place in our hearts that will always be reserved for you. We thank you for the gift your living brought to each of us. We love you. We sing our hymn, O Come, Emmanuel. There we go. Technical difficulties. This is the poem Nativity by Gerhard Fromm. I visited my friend today. He's 85 and travels light, a wise and wonderful man. We spoke of many things, small talk and big talk. And when I rose to leave, he said, yes, for most of our comings and goings, maps are okay. But for the big trip, we will follow a star. Thanks to you, elder brother, wandering in my wilderness, man of faith and vision, you keep Christmas in my heart.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. For our response, even if you're at home and we can't hear each other, I'm going to invite you to respond to each of these verses. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation. One thing I ask of the Lord, that I will seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in the Lord's temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud, be gracious to me and answer me. Come, my heart says, seek the Lord's face. Your face, O Lord, I seek. Do not hide your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are the persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My virtual friends, I know that this can seem a cold way to reach out. I've been practicing doing this kind of celebration more than I would like to. A year ago, none of us would have thought this is where we would be, talking to each other through a computer or on a screen. And I am certain that none of you thought that in this mid-December afternoon that you and your family would be gathered in sorrow instead of joy. That there would be a longing inside of you, not for the day of celebration to come, but for the day of returning to God and being reunited with those who you love so much who are no longer amongst you. A longing for any time, but this time. This time when our hearts remember so much that the memories crowd in and the absences fill us up until our hearts break and our eyes overflow with sorrow that we cannot understand. And so at this time, we listen to the wisdom of scriptures that said everything has a purpose and a time. The one thing the reading doesn't tell us is why. Why this time? Why this purpose? Why this moment? Jesus comes to us in the gospel and he says to us, blessed are those who mourn, who know that they have been loved, who long for what they have lost, for it will come to them. And so today we know, and I know, that as we read these names that we will listen to, as we hear each one of them, while they will go by us quickly, those names are a lifetime of love, a lifetime of experience, long nights of missing and loneliness, but they are a promise, because our faith tells us that we can rejoice and be glad, for even in this very difficult time in between, in this waiting for the coming of God to explain all things, to heal all hearts, to wipe away all tears and reunite all people. In this time, we wait in stillness and cold and dark, but filled with the light of hope, the warmth of love, and the absolute trust that we have a God who keeps his promises. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to you, O Israel. And now our musicians, Emily and Dana, will share a special song.
You never as I want it. I'm not gonna promise that cold winds won't blow. So when hard times abound you and your fears surround you, wrap my love around you, you're never alone. You're never.
Songs of redemption, how Jesus to Bethlehem came, and how they call his name Jesus, that all might be saved through his name. We'll sing once again with the angels, the message they sang that blessed morn, when shepherds first heard the glad story that Jesus the Savior was born. Oh dear ones, I wish you could be here. No Christmas on earth can compare with all the rapture and glory we witness in heaven so fair. You know how I always loved Christmas. It seemed such a wonderful day, with all of my loved ones around me, so happy and so gay. Yes, now I can see why I love it, and oh, what a joy it will be when you, my loved ones, are with me to share in the glories I see. So, dear ones on earth, here's my greeting. Look up till the day's dawn appears. Oh, what a Christmas awaits us beyond our parting of tears.
Time we will be calling a list of names, those who have died in the last year. We have an angel bearing the name of each person And as we call the names, we will be placing the angels on our tree. You should be aware that the angels are gifts to the families that we have served. You're welcome to come and pick those up beginning next week. Please just call us ahead of time and we will help you with that. Sharon Tolkis. Mary Gilb. Linda Wittrock. George Double D. Clara D. Rohde. Laverne Evers.
Thank you.
Dina Davenport.
Thank you.
George Baker. Gail Bud Bernardi.
Hymn, the first one.